This is Land Pride / Kubota. Why is it next to us?
Well, I would say the main reason that you can trust this is because rotary cutters are our bread and butter.
Yep.
The fact that you run it hydraulically in a skid steer doesn't change the fact that our cutter technology and our experience speaks volumes to what you can expect out of it. I mean, you can see by the size of the gearbox, our drive motors, and then we use a rubber coupler there to help with shock load when you hit something.
Yep. Heavy, is this high flow or just regular standard flow?
It's hard to tell. Those are standard flow couplers.
But yeah, you can order it either way, and then that's a different motor. So that you want the blades running at the same speed. Size the motor based on the end user's machine. And we use a case drain to help protect the seals in the motor. So when you do get up against something and you bog the motor down, that oil can escape and get back to the sump without.
So is this not
seals.
Is this not a normal thing with normal?
Some of them don't put it.
Okay.
Some do.
Okay.
Then our skid steer cutter line, we now have them. This is a 2-inch capacity cut. We have a 4-inch capacity cut.
Oh, really?
We have a 7-inch that has a folding door at the front so you can actually saw it. You can chop trees down and then drive over them. And on the bottom of the dish pan, it's got carbide teeth under there so you can grind the stump down and shred what they've knocked down. We just will be introducing a 6-inch unit that's just like that 7-inch.
But it's light enough that it has to be a 75 commander.
Really?
Yeah.
So okay.
We'll have a 6-inch capacity, but this unit has 2 blades under there. The 4-inch has 3, and the 7-inch and 6-inch have 4 blades. So it's just, you take them, as you get into bigger material, each cut takes less of a bite.
So this runs in float when you're going?
You can.
Or do you just put it down?
You just put it down, and then the way our with these chains, then that allows it to follow the contour of the ground. And the front gauge wheel is optional. If you put this on a machine that's big and beefy, like an SDL 65 or 75, some people don't want that because their machine's heavy enough. But if you're on a small skid steer that's a little marginal weight-wise, then that helps support the front end so you don't get that bucket.
And it's easy adjust.
Right.
So that's why a lot of people don't adjust things.
Right. Because
you got wrenches and right. You got to go. But this thing is just crank, easy adjust.
Up so and down. Yeah. You mow a little and you say, oh, we need to be lower. It's easy to adjust.
Okay.
The standard are the chain guards to protect the operator. And
front and back.
Front and back. So it keeps stuff under the machine. It keeps stuff from becoming airborne.
Yeah.
If you hit a rock, it'll keep it on the ground so that it doesn't